Very Short Stories. Master Willie. Once upon a time, there was a little boy named Willie. His surname was unknown, and he lived way over the mountains, too far to find out. Willie was a blond-haired, blue-eyed boy who exuded a unique kind of happiness. Just looking at him would make you feel all warm and fuzzy, making you dream of future adventures when you're a little older and stronger. Willie resided with his tall, wealthy aunt in a grand house at the edge of their village. Every day he'd take a stroll down the street, cradling his little wooden goat under his arm. As he passed, villagers would watch him and say, "There goes our little Master Willie." His aunt was exceptionally tall, with a long neck that supported her head, and she always wore a white cap. To Willie, the cap looked like a snowy peak atop a mountain. Although his aunt loved him, she was quite old and spent most of her time in deep reflection, often forgetting the games and stories she'd known as a child. When Willie asked about them, she'd advise him to go out and play in the woods, indicating she desired her solitude. Willie once had a beloved little sister named Apple-blossom, but something unusual happened to her. One day she overwound her gigantic walking and talking doll, which triggered an odd occurrence. As soon as the doll's winding key was removed, it took control. It grabbed Apple-blossom's hand, announcing that she was now the doll's little girl, and led her away to an unknown location. Willie and his aunt were left only with the knowledge that Apple-blossom had gone to a strange place where dolls wielded more power than people. After losing Apple-blossom, Willie found solace only in his wooden goat. It was a simple, hornless toy with hardly any hair, but it was precious to him. One day, the blacksmith's wife questioned Willie's affection for the wooden toy, given it wasn't alive. But Willie replied, "But if it were alive, anyone could love it." The miller's wife added that it was made by living hands and urged him to take care of it for the sake of its creators. Willie agreed and wondered about those hands as he continued on his daily journey. Willie spent his days in the woods, helping other children gather nuts and berries. As they returned home with full aprons, he'd watch them enviously, wishing he had his own family to bring food back to. He often told them how fortunate they were to have a simple life with their families, while they responded by reminding him of the wealth he possessed. To this, Willie replied that the satisfaction they derived from food was due to hunger, and there was no sorrow in their homes. One afternoon, Willie sat by the pond with his toy goat. As he watched the pond, it began to elongate, turning into a vast river. Little boats appeared and floated towards Willie, and one stopped near him. A mysterious voice asked, "Are you ready, Willie?" He replied that he needed a bit more time, but the voice insisted he board. Trusting the voice, he climbed aboard and began his journey down the river. Eventually, he arrived at a land populated with dolls who seemed to be expecting him. He clung to his wooden goat tightly as he called out for Apple Blossom. She responded, revealing that she was now filled with a wire spring and sawdust. She urged him to go home, bring money to buy her freedom, and then return for her. But the dolls crowded around, blocking his boat. He had no choice but to continue forward into the unknown. By the time he reached the land of storybooks, he was fast asleep. There, I found him. I gently woke him up with a kiss and placed him into my book for a rest. That's how he became a part of this tale for you to discover. Back in Toyland, Apple Blossom waits, and back home, his tall aunt mourns their absence. But fear not, dear children. I predict a happy ending. One day, the tall aunt will hear joyous voices calling her. She'll look up to find Willie and Apple Blossom standing in front of her. Apple Blossom will be free from the doll's control, her body no longer filled with wire springs and sawdust. The aunt will greet them with loving kisses, even the wooden goat, as she contemplates purchasing a new tail for him. And though she may not say much, her heart will sing a song of pure joy. That's a melody of love, dear children, sung only for those who hold us dear.
Join our community of kids who love to learn and have fun by subscribing to our channel.